Time now for News Talk, and Deb Cabral is joining us now. She's the DeClutter coach, and you can watch her program right here on WKTV on the weekends early in the morning, right?
Yes, Sunday morning at 7.
And then it runs again on our CW stations throughout the week.
Yes, Sunday at 10, so that's sometimes a little better for people, and then during the week several times at 1 o'clock in the
afternoon. Okay, good. So we are taking calls about getting organized. If you have any simple questions about maybe sprucing up the basement, the junk drawer, anything like that, little tips that she can give out, any questions you have, we encourage you to give us a call at 793-WKTV, 793-WKTV. While we wait for phone calls, I want to talk about this thing you have going on with TLC.
Yes.
So explain this. Start from the beginning with this, I guess.
Okay, it's very exciting. I'm a member of NAPO, as you know, the National Association of Professional Organizers, and we have an annual convention. So this year was in Baltimore. It was just a few weeks ago, and I happened to, by chance, meet the casting director of TLC's Hoarding Buried Alive, and we got to talking, and I had told him that we have a local show here in Utica, New York, and he was very impressed with that, and he said, would you be interested in being on the show? And so I said, well, let me look into it a little. I had seen the show before, but I was confusing it with some of the other hoarding programs.
There's a lot of hoarding programs.
Yeah, and, you know, my thing is I didn't want to be involved in a show that was going to exploit somebody, because this is really a serious issue. So,
and the thing with this show, too, because this is Buried Alive, Hoarding Buried Alive.
Hoarding Buried Alive on
and
TLC.
What this show does is it takes someone like you who has experience with getting organized mm-hmm. and putting everything, you know, in its proper place.
Yeah.
But then it also brings in someone that can take care of
the
mental aspect.
Absolutely.
Of it. Because people get attached to these items, for example.
They do. And usually hoarding is a result of some type of an emotional trauma that somebody could, you know, face. It could be the loss of a loved one, it could be loss of a job, severe depression, whatever it could be. Mm-hmm. So when I did the research and watched a few of the episodes, I saw that they were really interested in getting the people well. And then I had multiple conversations with the producers there, and I agreed to do it. But I really wanted to help someone here right in our community.
So the way it works here is that if you can find someone here locally, that's even better.
Yes.
But otherwise, if we can't, we'll go with someone nationally.
Yeah, they're going to send me somewhere. But I want to bring this national show right here to Central New York, to our community.
So we have a casting call going
on. We do.
And this is how it works. We want you to send us your information to decluttercoachdeb.com. Now, explain, what do you want to hear from the people who want to participate?
Yes, what we're looking for is for a family or an individual that is in need of help because of chronic disorganization and extreme clutter. The person that has the issue has to be willing to help. We have gotten some responses from family members, but once we do some investigating, the person is really not ready yet. So the person has to be ready. Now, there is compensation, so for being on the show, you are compensated by the show. Mm-hmm. They pay for all of the services for me and my team to come in and help get them organized. They also pay for the services of a therapist to come in and work with that person.
I think that's the key part
right there. It is key. And they'll also pay for follow-up services for me to come in and work with them on, you know, a few month basis after, and same with the therapist. The therapist will come in for up to 6 months. So they're really about making someone well, and I want to give a family here in our area, it's basically a second chance on life for these people. It really is.
And you'd be surprised, and I mean, some people that I've talked to, and I didn't even know this about them, and I find out that they're bordering on being a hoarder. I mean, a lot of people have a hard time getting rid of things.
Yeah, they really do. They get attached to their stuff, and the thing is, the emotional attachment sometimes is because those items belong to someone that you've lost, or it could just be having all of that around you makes you feel safe. It's, you know, anxiety-based, too.
It's interesting, too, because if I had all of that stuff around me, I would feel unsafe.
Yes, I would,
isn't that
too,
weird,
but
though?
That's our personality. Yeah,
yeah.
And everybody's different. And, you know, one of the things that I try to tell people, even when we work, you know, we do work with some hoarders in the area that, you know, are on the hoarding spectrum, but they don't want to be on television. They don't want to be on TLCs.
Yeah.
They don't want to be on our show. But I have a lot of compassion for these type of people because I really feel that, you know, when you look at other types of addiction, whether it's alcohol addiction or drug addiction, whatever it may be, you know, we all have issues. There's nobody mm-hmm. out there that doesn't. So I always tell people, it doesn't matter what it looks like now. It doesn't matter why I got here. We're here to help you and to make it better. It
matters what it can look like.
Right. And what's your vision? That's what I always tell people. What is your vision? What do you want this area to look like? What do you want your life to be like? And we can help you get there.
One quick call. Go ahead. You're live in the air. What's your question?
Yes. I was wondering, I hear conflicting reports in regards to legal papers, how long you should keep them and everything.
Legal papers?
Yes.
How
what
long?
Type of legal papers?
Are you still there?
Yeah.
What kind? Yeah, what kind of legal papers?
Oh, checks,
Well, you don't.
I don't know.
Checks that you've written for bills, you don't need to save checks. Right now, a lot of banks are going to scanning, so you can always recreate those. Checks, what I suggest is 6 months. Unless you need them for tax purposes, if you've filed your tax returns and you have deductions that you're taking, again, you can be audited up to 7 years, so you want to save any bills, receipts, anything associated with that up to 7 years. But other than that, what we teach our clients is keep things for one calendar year. So all of your credit card receipts, your Niagara Mohawk National Grid bills, I usually set up folders for people and say, once your April of 2012 bill comes in, get rid of your April of 2011. Don't need it.
All right.
So just keep rotating.
All right, good. So simple.
So simple.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Don, for having us.
And coming up in the next half hour, Bill Curtis is going to join us. And two